save some of that for me.
What happened? Did you see her? How'd she look? What did she say to you? Oh, please, go ahead. We can just drown our sorrows in sugar. Ned, I am waiting. What happened?
Yes, I saw Lois.
Will she forgive you? More importantly, will she forgive me?
Good morning, Mrs. Cirillo.
Sonny Corinto. Whoa, what a blast from the past. What, I opened my kitchen door and, oh, what is this? Is there, huh?
Been a while.
Oh, yeah.
How you doing?
Fine.
Good.
Not so fine. Imagine, I mean, you know what's going on.
Yeah.
Hey, you know what? You look good.
Yeah, well, so do you.
Yeah. Considering there was a time that I wasn't sure you would make it through the 80s.
Yeah, well, I surprised a lot of people. How's Lois doing?
You can't imagine. Her heart is broken. Oh, I'd like to skin that creep alive. But you know, at least now, she's home with her family, and we're taking care of her.
She's very lucky to have you. And I've been worried about her, and I'd like to see you.
Dad, please tell me what happened.
I was right, Brenda. I told you that first night we drove to Buffalo. Lois was in love with Eddie Main, not Ned Ashton. She hates me.
Well, I don't blame her.
Thank you very much.
And you know what? Don't be too sure that it's only Ned Ashton that she hates. You both lied to her.
I came clean. I told her how afraid I was of losing her, all about the blackmail with Catherine, everything. And all she did was ask for a ring back.
See, why should she believe you now after all those months of lying?
Because I told her the whole truth. That should have been enough.
It's not enough, Ned. You didn't tell her the truth. She discovered it on her own, and then you did damage control. And you know, how many times did I tell you?
Don't say I told you so. Don't gloat.
You think that I am enjoying any of this? You know, if she won't forgive you, she certainly won't forgive me.
Yeah, but she has to forgive me. I just have to give her a little more time and then somehow get her to hear what I'm saying.
Okay. Was there anything else, Ned? Anything? I mean, after she told you that she hated you and demanded her ring back, did she show any sign of cracking, even a little bit?
None. Her family did threaten to dismember me, so they won't be any help.
What a mess. But wait a minute. You're still wearing her ring. Why didn't you give it back to her?
I can't give it back. Maybe all I have left of her.
Believe me, Mrs. C, I don't mean any trouble.
I've been seeing a lot of Lois these days, and her well-being is very important to me.
The record company, yeah. Oh, she's so excited about that. My baby thought all her dreams had come true. I want you to swear a solemn oath, Sonny, on your blessed mother's grave. May she rest in peace. That you had nothing to do with this betrayal.
I can do better than that. On my mother's grave, if I had known what Ned was doing, I'd have put a stop to it. I go too far back with this family to stand by while any one of you is threatened in any way.
Thank you.
You're welcome. In fact, I was surprised as a nice guy, you know, to see Lois pop out of that cake.
What? She what?
She didn't tell you?
No.
That's how she blew the lid off the whole scam at Catherine's birthday party. You know who Catherine is?
Yeah, I put a pox on her.
Good for you. Anyway. She threw this fancy birthday party for herself at a restaurant. They wheeled in this massive cake, out jumps Lois, right? Hands her marriage license to the Barracuda and takes off. I'm telling you, it was one hell of an entrance.
My baby, she doesn't take this bad stuff lying down. She is a fighter.
Well, she's got a lot of moxie, yeah. That's for sure. Thank you.
Honey, Sonny and I were just chatting.
It's all right, Ma. We ain't gonna kill each other.
All right. If you need me, I'll be inside.
I'm sorry, okay, about all this, and it's horrible, okay?
Stop it. There's only one thing I want to hear. Did you know?
Not a clue, I swear. Brenda never let on, and I'm not happy about that either.
See what happens when people lie, huh?
Yeah.
Nothing good ever comes of it. So were you two fighting?
We were. You know, I was furious with her for not telling me the truth, for doing what she did to you, for putting in jeopardy what we're all trying to do together with LMB.
Yeah, well, I guess she blew it.
But it's breaking her heart, Lois. More than anything, not being your friend is killing her. You gotta just at least give her a shot to...
Don't talk to me about broken heart, Sonny. I'm the walking wounded here, remember?
I know, but I'm telling you, she's owning up to her part in this, and she's taking responsibility.
Well, it's too late.
Maybe not. We all know how important this company is to you, to all of us. And even with that, Brenda said she'd back down, step away, if that's what you wanted. But I'm hoping it doesn't come to that. I guess it was just her way of trying to give back a little bit of what you gave to her.
Don't you ask me not to be angry, Sonny. It's the only thing I'm holding on to right now, and if I let that go, I'm telling you all the heart's gonna come rushing in, and I'm just gonna die. I know I will.
You should be mad, Lois. You have every right. What was it that your mother used to say? Don't throw the baby out with the
bathwater. Yeah, I know. She still says it all the time.
Well, now I'm saying it. Whatever else is happening, LMB might be the one good thing out of this. It's important to me, and it's important to Miguel. Wait. You did a hell of a good job convincing that kid you were the answer to his prayers. Now he's out there hanging, wondering where his future is.
Well, he is so talented. Don't worry, he'll survive.
You are the key to the company's success. However you decide to play this out with that creep you married is your call. But professionally speaking, even without the outer rich, Miguel is ready to bust out. We have your nose for talent, and you have me and Brenda, if whatever, I don't care if you want her, behind you all the way. The bottom line is, you are the spark plug that makes LMB run. We are useless without you.
Honey, I don't know. I don't know what to... It just hurts so bad.
Whatever it takes, I have to spend the rest of my life with her. I can't imagine it any other way.
It's not only up to you, Ned.
I'll do whatever she asks of me, even if it takes every penny I have.
Oh, you still don't get it, do you? Lois does not care about the money.
What am I going to do? How else do I fight for this?
Persistence. You need to keep at her until she really believes that you loving her is the only thing that matters.
You didn't say her. Those eyes. Those gorgeous eyes. I used to look in those eyes and know that anything was possible. But there we were, just the two of us. And it had all changed. What I saw in those eyes was anger and betrayal. There was no more innocence anymore, no more sense of wonder. And when she said she hated me, I saw that in her eyes, too. And if I killed that, if I destroyed that in her, I will never forgive myself. And if I can't forgive myself, how can I ask her to forgive me?
Okay, you need to be realistic about this. I mean, did you honestly think that this was going to turn out otherwise?
Well, I wasn't thinking. I mean, I was in a fool's paradise. But what she doesn't realize is that everything I did was about loving her. It was about protecting her, about keeping us together.
I know, but this is a lot to ask of Lois, especially now that she knows that Catherine was waiting on the other end of the driveway that whole time.
Catherine. This is all her damn fault.
No, you know what? That is too easy. And believe me, I hate Catherine too, Ned, but you made this bed. Both beds.
You should have heard me trying to explain all this to Lois. I mean, I wasn't even halfway through and I thought to myself, what a crock. How did I get myself into this disgusting web of convoluted lies?
It's not all lies. I know that you really love her.
Thank you for knowing that. Thank you for believing.
I'm on your side, Ned. You know I've always been on your side. I mean, that's how I got myself into this mess in the first place, right?
I know. You're the only one who gets it.
I really can't help you tap dance your way out of it, not this time.
I know. So I'll just have to figure out a way to move heaven and earth all by myself.
Oh, well, there you are, Ned. Back from your wandering.
And you've got me.
I want to know the whole program, A to Z. And what's the status of this inconceivably ridiculous mess that you've gotten yourself into?
Oh, I've got to go. I'll see everybody later.
You okay?
No. I feel like a first-class idiot. I was taken by that con man.
You didn't know.
The very first words out of his mouth to me were lies, Sonny. Eddie Main, pharmaceutical salesman. I mean, it all went downhill from there. How can a man live with that?
I guess he avoids looking in the mirror.
Every time he told me he loved me, I fell for it.
According to Brenda, that may be the only thing that was the truth.
Oh, yeah, like so. I'm supposed to believe her.
Well, she said he was so nuts about you that he had to convince himself that lying to you was the only way to keep you. But whoa, now. You loved him too, right?
How can I love someone that I don't know? Oh, Sonny, no, he was so good at lying, man. He made me feel like we were something special, like we were the happiest couple on earth. And then he would kiss me goodbye and tell me he had to go hit the road to sell his stupid pills, you know? All the while, he was disappearing into that big fat mansion and crawling into bed with that big fat...
Lois, don't do that to yourself. You're never gonna know if you can forgive the man if you keep coming up with images to torture.
Whoa! Forgive him? Sonny, no. How can I do that? Listen to me, okay? The first thing that has always been most important in a relationship to me has been love. Then comes trust. If I am ever stupid enough to forgive that man, how on God's green earth do you think I am ever going to be able to trust him again?
Hi.
Don't worry about it.
Miguel, can I talk to you for a second?
Hi.
Okay?
Yeah. What about you?
Oh, yeah, I just wanted to come and tell you that, you know, even if Lois never speaks to me again, even if I have to back off from the day-to-day stuff at LMB, there's nothing for you to worry about because your CD is still going to be out on the market and your career, I know, is just going to take off like a rocket.
Sonny came here, and, well, he told me that he was 100% behind my career.
Good. He means it.
But, Brenda, I want you to be with us always. You're a very important part in this project. Come on, you mean a lot to me.
Thank you. I really want to be here for everything, but, you know, only if Lois forgives me. And that doesn't look too good right now.
You've got a lot to work out, Lois.
It's not my job to tell you what you should or shouldn't do about your marriage, but as a friend, you're not doing yourself any good sitting around Brooklyn licking your wounds.
What am I supposed to do?
Come back to Port Charles with me.
No. What? No, absolutely not. I don't want to see Eddie or anybody who's ever heard of him ever again. Besides, I can't face him.
It is not like you to hide. You got a lot more pride than that. You're a fighter. That's what I love about you.
What am I going to do there?
Do what you do best. Music. I need you. Miguel needs you. And I can't launch his career without you getting in my face telling me how much I'm screwing up. Right?
Well, you know, you are pretty humble.
I know. And you got to see Miguel through the next few weeks. You got to get to work. Do something you know you do well. And anyway, you'd kill yourself if you weren't there to reap the rewards of everything you started, right?
Yes, I could throw myself back into the work.
Yeah, you bet.
Well, if I stay here, I'm gonna drive myself crazy thinking about what a mess the rest of my life is.
Probably.
You know, I will confess something to you.
What?
You know, I love my folks, right? But I was lying in bed this morning thinking, you know, they take such good care of me. I don't ever have to leave this house ever again. You know, I don't want to do that. I mean, I got to get back into the world sometime.
Right. And the sooner you do, the sooner you show them all. Right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're right. Okay. No, I'll do it. I'll do it. No, I'm just going to go. I'm going to pack some bags, okay?
Yep.
You son of a thank you. Thank you so much, okay? Oh, Ma, I'm going back to Port Charles with Sonny.
What?
No, listen, I don't want any grief from you or from Pops, okay? This is something that I need to do, okay? Okay. She's home. She's safe in the bosom of her family. Why would you talk her into going back to that horrible place?
She's already lost one dream. You want to take the other one, too? I believe this record company is just the thing she needs to get her back on her feet. She loves the work. It makes her fly.
Yeah, I know that. I know. But what? If she runs into Eddie, she's going to get hurt again. I don't want to hurt again.
Neither do I.
She's still my little girl.
And I appreciate that. I wouldn't want her to come back, except I know she'll be looked after.
By you?
Those were my intentions.
Wouldn't be the first time, would it?
No, it wouldn't.
Who was that bully in the fourth grade? Who was it?
Jimmy Carlin,
yeah. Annette Carlin's son. He used to terrorize her for her lunch money. No, he's doing time.
Well, couldn't happen to a nicer guy.
Yeah. You know, Louie won't be with you this time.
Well, you know, I think I can handle it myself. I'm a little older and wiser, you know.
Yeah. It's kind of too bad, because I kind of like the idea of Eddie in a body cast.
Yeah. Well, hey, don't worry, Mrs. C. I'm going to take care of your daughter like she was my own sister.
And will you make sure that Mr. Ned Ashton keeps his distance?
I sure will, as long as that's what Lois wants.
Good for
you. Brenda, you've always been a good friend to Lois. Come on.
Yeah, I thought I was. I mean, I really wanted to be. You know, I don't know, Miguel. It's like I've never, ever had any girlfriends. Maybe it's because I never stayed in one place long enough. It seems like every time I'd started a new school, all these cliques would already be formed, and I would always feel left out. Maybe it's because everyone thought I was a snob. Or maybe they were jealous because I always got a lot of attention from all the guys.
Well, that's understandable.
I never even felt close to my sister. She was always far away, too. And Lois was the first one. She's like my kindred spirit.
And you're lucky.
No, Miguel. I can't stand the thought that we might not have that anymore.
Well, I feel bad for Lois. It is so bad when the people you trust the most have lied to you. I'm sorry she doesn't know who to trust now.
Miguel, you are not making me feel any better right now.
Well, I'm sorry, Brenda, but it's the truth. and it's going to take a while for her to feel comfortable again.
You know, I really want to blame this all on Ned because it really is all of his fault. And I can't even do that. Because I feel bad for him, too. You know, you don't even know how Ned used to be. Ned used to be like this self-centered playboy who didn't care about anybody. And Lois came around and just turned him into someone who actually cares about something. It's like Lois gave him his heart.
Well, there's something good came from it.
I wish that I had a magic wand. I wish that I could just change Ned into Eddie Main and he could just stay that way all the time, because that is the best part of Ned.
Everybody knows they belong together.
We all belong together. Don't you think? I mean, we're a team, right, Miguel?
Yes, we are. Huh?
I can't stand the thought of Lois not being in my life anymore. It's totally unbearable.